okay. 5 minutes before news time, and you've got another film to talk about.
Yeah, this one is Joy. This is one, the latest one from David O. Russell. Now, he's been out bringing out films over the last few years. You probably recognise Silver Linings Playbook and American Hustle. And he seems to be playing with the same cast. And because it's got Jennifer Lawrence in it again, it's got Robert De Niro in it again, and it's got Bradley Cooper in it again, which has been in the last two films that I've just spoke about. But this is actually, again, another true story. It's about a woman called Joy who actually invents the miracle mop. Now, if you know what the miracle mop is, it's one of those mops where you can actually syringe it. And she launched it for the first time on QVC, and we've got a little bit of a clip.
You said to me that David Selznick, the son of immigrants, married Jennifer Jones, an all-American girl from Oklahoma, because in America, all races and all classes can meet and make whatever opportunities they can. And that is what you feel when you reach into people's homes with what you sell. You said that.
Hmm. So this is a clip of Joy.
Yeah, so what she is, she's a woman with two kids. She's got a mother who stays at home with her. She's got a dad has just moved back in. She still lives with her ex-husband who's trying to be a musician. And it's all about her struggles. And she's been basically, she was the valedictorian at school. She should have been a success. And she actually pushes for that. And she actually became a multimillionaire. I'm not spoiling anything. She can actually look up all this on the internet, but it's how she got there and that journey, how she got there. It's an excellent performance again from Jennifer Lawrence. She will be up again for another Oscar nomination, I think, for this. And it's a great story of female empowerment, especially when it's set in the 70s and 80s. So it wasn't really, business women weren't really pushing themselves forward like they do this time in this decade. But it is slightly overlong, but again, I'm going to give it a big 4 stars because I think it is one of the riveting performance films and a really interesting story.